Good morning. So in this session, we will have the discussion about the problems on simplex method. Simplex method is one of the linear programming technique in operation research. So my topic covers operation research, origin of OR, objectives of OR, OR in action, applications of OR, linear programming, mathematical formulation of LPP, simplex method, problem on simplex method, and finally applications of LPP. Okay, so before going to the problems on simplex method, so let us see what is operation research. Operation, the activities carried out in an organization's research, the process of observation and testing characterized by the scientific model. For example, situation, problem statement, model construction, validation and experimentation, and it is a scientific approach to execute decision making that consists of the art of mathematical modeling of complex situations, the science of the development of solution techniques used to solve these models, and the ability to effectively communicate the results to the decision maker. Okay, next, the origin of operation research. So operation research originated in the efforts of military planners during the World War II. So the analytical study of military problems was undertaken to provide scientific basis for the decisions to improve military operations. See, after the two world wars, the techniques were more widely applied to problems in business, industries ranging from petrochemicals to airlines, finance, logistics, government and society, moving to a focus on the development of mathematical models that can be used to analyze and optimize complex systems. In India, it was first introduced at Kolkata and then Delhi, Kerala, so on. So next, why is OR needed? So because it makes the best use of available resources. Today's global markets mean that customers expect the best high quality of products and services when they need them. So organizations, whether public or private, they need to provide these product and services as effectively and efficiently as possible. This requires careful planning and analysis. That is the hallmarks of good operation research. Next, the objectives of operation research. So decision making and improve its quality, identify optimum solution, integrating the systems, minimize the cost and maximize the profit, improve the productivity, success in competition and market leadership. So applications of operation research are abundant, such as airlines, manufacturing companies, service of organizations, military branches and in government. So some of the actions of OR are given here. Scheduling of air queues and the fleet for airlines, and scheduling of vehicles in supply chains, scheduling of orders in a factory, and scheduling of operating theaters in the hospital. Facility planning, computer simulations of airports for the rapid and safe processing of travelers, improving appointments systems for medical practice. Planning and forecasting, identifying possible future developments in telecommunications, deciding how much capacity is needed in your holiday business. Yield management, setting the prices of airline seats and hotel rooms to reflect changing demand and the risk of no-shows. Credit scoring, deciding which customers offer the best prospects of credit companies. Marketing, evaluating the value of sale promotions, developing customer profiles and computing the lifetime value of the customer. And finally, defense and peacekeeping, finding ways to deploy troops rapidly. So these are the some more methods and techniques: computer simulation, optimization, probability and statistics, problem structure. So before entering into our problem, so we will discuss about the one of the optimization technique, that is linear programming problem. Solving linear programming problem, we have so many methods such as graphical method, simplex method, dual simplex method and artificial variable method, Bigham method, etc. So linear programming problem is an optimization technique developed during the World War II for use in optimizing the allocation of labor and material critical to the war effort. So linear programming can be done graphically only in two or three variables. So in the problems in three variables requires the graph in three dimensions, then linear programming in more than three variables requires the use of special algorithm. So one of the algorithm is simplex method. So therefore the linear programming problem consists of a linear objective function to be maximized or minimized subject to the certain constraints in the form of linear equations or inequalities. So a linear programming problem consists of three components: decision variables, the objective and the constraints. So let us see the solutions of LPP. So a basic solution to a system of m linear equations in n unknowns is obtained by setting n minus m variables to 0 and solving the resulting system to get the values of other m variables. The variables obtained by solving the system are called basic solution. The variables set to 0 are called non-basic solution. So if all the basic variables are non-negative, then the solution is called the basic feasible solution. Okay, let us move to the problem on simplex method. It's a production problem. So as novelty wishes to produce two types of souvenir, type A will result in a profit of $1 and type B in a profit of $1.20. To manufacture a type A souvenir requires 2 minutes on machine 1 and 1 minute on machine 2. A type B souvenir requires 1 minute on machine 1 and 3 minutes on machine 2. There are 3 halves available on machine 1 and 5 halves available on machine 2. Now the question is, how many souvenirs of each type should A make in order to maximize its profit? So first we formulate the problem mathematically. So there are 2 basic LP models: the maximization model in standard form and the minimization model in standard form. Then the general mathematical formulation of LPP is objective function is optimize z, that is maximize or minimize z is equal to c1 x1 plus etc plus cn xn subject to the inequalities ai1 x1 plus etc plus ain xn less than or equal to or greater than or equal to bi, where I is equal to 1, 2, etc, m. So which are called the constraints. Then the constraints x1 greater than or equal to 0, x2 greater than or equal to 0, etc, xn greater than or equal to 0 are called the non-negativity constraints. Okay, let us see this mathematical formulation in detail. Okay, first, this is the procedure for forming LPP model. The step one is identify the unknown variables to be determined and assign symbols to them. The next step, identify all the restrictions or constraints in the problem and express them as linear equations or inequalities of decision variables. Identify the objective or A and represent it also as a linear function of decision variables. And finally, express the complete formulation of LPP as a general mathematical model. We have discussed above the general mathematical formulation of LPP. Okay. Next, we see decision variables. A decision variable is a quantity that the decision maker controls. For example, the number of nurses to employ during the morning shift in an emergency room may be a decision variable in an optimization model for labor scheduling. Next, in the objective function and in the constraints, z is equal to so x1, x2, etc., xn are decision variables, and c1, c2, etc., cn are cost coefficients. So cost coefficients means with each decision variable that is associated a cost, that is loss or a profit gain for each unit change in the variable. So these values are represented by the cost or profit coefficients. So let us first tabulate the given information for above discussed problem. So in our problem, two types of products are manufacturing by using two different machines, and type A in a profit of souvenir and type B in a profit of $1.20. Okay, the two types of products and time availability are given in column wise two different machines 1 and 2 and profit are in the row wise. The values are given in the cells related to both products and machines. So let us define the first component of LPP, that is decision variable. So let x be the number of type A souvenirs and y be the number of type B souvenirs to be made. Next, the component, second component of LPP, that is objective function. The objective function is an equation representing the profit or cost, that is maximizing the profit or minimizing the cost related to the decision variables. The objective functions take one of the following forms according to profit and or cost coefficients. P is equal to P1 X1 plus etc. PK XK. C is equal to C1 X1 plus etc. CK XK. Here P denotes the profit and C denotes the cost. The objective is to maximizing the profit and minimizing the cost. Therefore, the total profit for our problem is given by P is equal to X plus 1.2Y. Here we use the formula for profit, that is number of units into price. From the table, the decision variables are multiplied by their corresponding cost coefficients and then sum it. So in that problem, coefficients are $1 and $1.20. So that is type A in a profit of $1 and type B in a profit of $1.20. Next is the third component of LPP, that is constraints. So if this is in the form of inequalities like this, that describe mathematically the limitations on the resources. Normally, for a cost objective function, the inequalities will be greater than or equal to, and for a profit objective, the inequalities will be less than or equal to constants. So the next one is non-negativity constraints. The decision variables may take on the negative values. So it is that is x1, x2, etc., xn are greater than or equal to 0. These constraints are called non-negativity constraints. Next is the constraints construction for the problem. So from the table, the total amount of time that machine 1 is used is 2x plus y. Then that is the decision variables are multiplied by the time requirement to manufacture the products on machine 1. So that is time requirement for type A and B on machine 1 are 2 minutes and 1 minutes respectively. So and the time availability is given here. So that is 3 hours. Time availability on machine 1 is 3 hours. So it must not exceed 180 minutes. Thus we have the inequality 2x plus y is less than or equal to 180. Similarly, so we the second inequality, so that is x plus 3y is less than or equal to 300. Then further, finally, neither x nor y can be negative. So x greater than or equal to 0 and y greater than or equal to 0. So therefore, the mathematical formulation for our problem is P is equal to the objective function, P is equal to x plus 1.2y subject to the system of inequalities 2x plus y less than or equal to 180, x plus 3y is less than or equal to 300, the non-negativity constraints x greater than or equal to 0, y greater than or equal to 0. So let us come to our main topic, that is the simplex method. The simplex method is an iterative procedure beginning at a vertex of feasible region S. Each iteration brings us to another vertex of S with an improved value of the objective function. The iteration ends when the optimum solution is reached. So feasible region is the region defined by the set of coordinates that satisfies the system of inequalities. Next. So these are the simplex algorithm. So let us apply this algorithm to our production formula. So the objective function p is equal to x plus 1.2y can be rewritten as p is equal to x plus 6 by 5y, and then subject to the constraints 2x plus y is less than or equal to 180, x plus 3y is less than or equal to 300, and xy is greater than or equal to 0. So to solve this, we have to add the slack variables to convert the inequalities into the equation. So in an optimization problem, a slack variable is a variable that is added to the inequality constraint to transform it to an equality. So why this slack variables? So consider this example. So consider the large block constraint 2x plus y is less than or equal to 6. The economic interpretation of this constraint is the number of large blocks used to assemble tables plus the number of large blocks used to assemble chairs cannot exceed the 6 units of large blocks in inventory. Suppose we built one chair and one table. So in order to determine how many blocks we have left in stock, so compare the left hand side and subtract it from 6, we have 3 blocks left in stock. That is, put x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 1 in the left hand side, so we have 3, and this 3 is subtracted from 6, so we have 3 blocks in the stock. So accountants prepare another approach. They create a new account. So actually the relation can be expressed as the number of large blocks used to assemble tables plus the number of large blocks used to assemble chairs plus the number of large blocks left in inventory must equal the 6 units of large blocks in this originally stock. So mathematically defined, 2x plus y plus s is equal to 6. Here s is a new variable that keeps tracks of the large blocks inventory. So by simply checking the slack variable, so once one can tell how many blocks are idle, that is not being used in production. So we no need to recalculate the balances. Okay, let us introduce the slack variables u and v into the inequalities. So this inequality becomes the equations, that is 2x plus y plus u is equal to 180, x plus 3y plus v is equal to 300, and the objective function can be written as minus, that is p is equal to x plus 6 by 5y can be written as minus x minus 6 by 5y plus p is equal to 0. Therefore, we have 3 equations. With these 3 equations, let us construct the initial simplex table. So, initial simplex table here, in the first row, we have the 5 variables x, y, u, v, p. So the values in the first row are the coefficients of x, y, u, v, p in the first equation. So that is, so the coefficient of x is 2, the coefficient of y is 1, and coefficient of u is 1. So we have no variables in the u, v and p in the first equation. So the variable set to 0. So the first row is 2, 1, 1, 0, 0, and 180. In the same way, we can write the other two rows. Okay, next step is determine the whether the optimal solution has been reached. So check whether all the entries in the last row, objective function row, are positive or not. If all the entries are positive, then optimal solution is reached. if any one occurs, we have to perform pivot operation. So since there are negative entries in the last row of the table, the initial solution is not optimal. So we have to perform the pivot operation. So let us see in detail. Choose the column with the most negative element in the objective function row. Since entry -6 by 5 is the most negative entry to the left of the vertical line in the last row of the table, here the second column is the pivot column. Divide on entries in the constant column by the corresponding entries in the pivot columns and compare the ratio. Here the ratio is 180 by 1 is equal to 180 and 300 by 3 is equal to 100, and find the least ratio, that is 100 here. So this the corresponding row is called the pivot row. Okay, the entry 3 lying in the pivot column and the pivot row, so which is called the pivot element. So now in this figure, 3 is lying in the both pivot row and pivot column, so that element is the pivot element. So next step is convert the pivot element into 1. Divide that pivot row by pivot element, so that pivot element will be converted into 1. So using the elementary row operations to convert the pivot column into a unit column. So that is, convert all the entries in the pivot column to 0 except the pivot element which remains 1. That operation, row operations are given here. So that is R1 for the first row, the operation is R1 minus R2. Adding R1, row 1 and minus R2 for the first row. Then the third row is R3 plus 6 by 5 R2. So this completes the first iteration. So again check whether all the entries in the last row are positive or not. So the last row of the table contains the negative number. So an optimal solution has not been reached. So we go to the next, again perform the pivot operation. So since the entry -3 by 5 is the most negative entry to the left of the vertical line in the last row of the table, so therefore the first column in the table is now the pivot column. So find the ratio obtained by dividing the elements in the constant column by their corresponding elements in the pivot columns and they compare the ratio. So here the ratio, least ratio is 48. So that corresponding row is pivot row. Here the 5 by 3, the element 5 by 3 is pivot element which is lying in the pivot column and pivot row. So that element, convert that element into 1. The pivot element should be converted into 1 by dividing the row with 5 by 3, that is 3 by 5R1. So using the elementary row operations to convert the pivot column into a unit column. So make all the entries in that column to 0 and except the pivot element. The operations are given. So that is, the second row is obtained by adding R2 and -1 by 3 R1, and then third row is obtained by R3, adding R3 and 3 by 5 R1. So the last, check whether the last row of the entries of the last row are positive or not. So here from the table, the last row of the table contains no negative numbers, so an optimal solution has been reached. So next, determine the optimal solution. So locate the basic variables in the final table. So in this case, the basic variables are x, y and p. The optimal value for x is 48, the optimal value for y is 84, The optimal value for P is 148.8. Thus, the firm will maximize profits at $148.80 by producing 48 type A sovereigns and 84 type B sovereigns. Next, let us see the applications of LPP. So, linear programming techniques are used in many industrial and economic problems. They are applied in product mix, blending, diet, transportation and assignment problems, oil refineries, airlines, railways, textile industries, chemical industries, steel industries, food processing industries and defense establishments. Thank you.